What's up, zombie slayers? This is KJ4E. Welcome back to my 7 Days to Die single player Let's Play. This is episode 10, and this is for real. Check it out. You know what that means? Horde night. Now, I have not heard. I'm scared. I'm really scared. I kind of rebuilt my area a little bit here. Try and make it a little bit better. I'm really worried about the spider zombies climbing up the walls. For those of you who don't know, there's a zombie in the game called spider zombies that can crawl up walls to get to you. So just because you're on a roof doesn't mean you're completely safe. So I'm just sitting up here taking a look at the blood moon. That's the blood moon. That signifies that we are in the middle of the horde night. So we're going to see how this goes. Now, as you can see on the bottom left hand side of my... Actually, those look a little weird, don't they? If you look on the bottom left-hand side, you can see I have a thirst and hunger meter. These were made for me by Pam. I mentioned these before. They've updated to 13.3. It wasn't really a huge update, just some fixes here and there. They did change a couple things. Look at this. I'm actually cold. How about that? And I was just gonna like. Oh, you know what? I decided not to bring my jacket out anymore. So now that I decided not to bring my jacket with me, it's getting cold, and I don't have one. Oh my goodness, well, what are we supposed to do about that? Well, let's see, what can we do? We could probably make some armor. Let's see what we're actually wearing. We actually have quite a bit of stuff on. They must have changed something, because it's only 36 degrees out, man. Like, now I'm really cold. I think they did something with the temperature on 13.3. I read the notes quickly. Didn't seem like anything too interesting, but there is a couple changes on the clothes. As a matter of fact, I could do this right now. The bandana has -5 insulation, so if I take that off, I'll get some more wait. Is my guy bugged? Am I not seeing this properly? Insulation on this brown plaid shirt is 10%. But my overall insulation... Oh, the hat. That's right. The hat's taking away 10%. There we go. Now we've got more insulation. Yeah, and you can see now we're warming up. Okay, so they did change a couple things. The cowboy hat's always had negative insulation, which means it'll keep you cooler. But they also make it so the bandana has negative insulation. So that's... I think that's a... I want to say a 7% insulation swing, because I think it was +2 before. So yeah, there's that. They changed a couple things with the temperature. They're balancing it out, and I think it's going in good directions. And if you wonder why I'm talking quietly, it's because I'm just role playing a little bit. So the hunger and thirst meter. I thought that they would put the hunger and thirst meter back on 13.3. They decided against it. But looking at my hunger and thirst meter, it looks a little weird. It looks like about halfway there, there's like a little line going down the middle. Like, if you look at the thirst meter and the hunger meter, like on the left side, the blue is darker than on the right side, or like a different shade. So I don't know what that's all about, but whatever. That's gonna bother me every time I look at it. But it's not really a priority. I'm also taking to clearing out my inventory a little bit more thoroughly. Normally I carry around a lot of stuff, but I'm gonna really try and carry around quite a bit less. Like, only the necessities. I want a wrench because I want to hit cars. I want a shovel because I want to get clay. Although I won't be going for clay on this one, so let's just leave it up there. I am trying to use up the rest of my stone arrows. Although stone arrows is pretty good. I think I mentioned this last video. Stone arrows are pretty good for hunting, because they have a higher bleed chance. So, you know, you make something bleed, and then the deer starts running away, and then they die from the bleeding. So these are not totally useless. So I have to keep that in mind. I still want to use them all, but as of right now, some people don't know how to change arrows with the bow. You just hold down R, and then it shows you all the arrows. So, but right now I'm using the good arrows, because if a spider zombie crawls up here, I want to kill him as fast as possible. Although, I don't know, it doesn't seem like there's anybody out here. And they should have been here by now. The 7-day hordes are notoriously bugged. You know, sometimes they come, sometimes they don't. They were pretty good last season. Last season they were pretty good. But it doesn't seem like they're coming now. So I'm not really sure what's up with that. From what I understand, the first 7 days... Okay, maybe I should explain this to the new players because I'm trying to like really educate the newbies. Okay, the 7-day horde is a super horde that comes every 7 days and it knows exactly where you are. There's no hiding from it. As the days go on, it'll come every 7 days, 7, 14, 21, 28, and so on. And as the days go on, every 7-day horde grows in power. You'll eventually have hornets and cops and dogs and like feral zombies. Feral zombies are kind of like boss zombies. They have a ton of hit points and they drop really good loot. Here we go. No? By the way, I could take apart this air conditioner with the wrench, but I don't want to make the noise right now. Alright, well, it doesn't look like there's going to be much action up here. What I'm going to do is I'm going to pause the video, and if I start getting attacked, I will just start it back up. So, see you then. Okay, we're back, and it is almost 6 a.m. That was a whole lot of nothing, guys. I don't know what happened there. So, we're just going to grab our stuff, and we are going to go exploring. We're going to explore up here to the north. Again, I need to know if this is going to be a place I'm going to want to stay. But if there's nothing to loot in the area, it might not be worth staying here. So, honestly, I think we need to spend most of our time right now looting anyway. Yeah. Should I take a jacket with me? Probably not. Let's just go. I don't think I'm gonna need a jacket. Although with the jacket, even with the hat and the bandana, I still don't think I'm gonna be able to wear a jacket. So, my number one concern right now is to start a base. And I need to know if this is a good place to make a base yet. So, I have an idea how I want to make a base. I'm gonna make a house I live in. Or I'm gonna, like, fortify a house that's a prefab. And then after that, I'm going to... what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna make a separate, like, structure. Which is where I'm gonna go to for the 7-day hordes. The biggest concern in this game, really, is the day 7 hordes. Hold on, let me kill this guy. Yeah, the biggest concern in this game is the Day 7 Hordes. Now, with that being said, I'm only going to worry about the Day 7 Hordes. The regular Hordes aren't that... Whoa. Oh, what am I doing up here? Oh, she's dead. Ooh, that's bugged. Oh, well. Anyway, yeah, so I'm going to have, like, a separate place I go to for the 7-day hordes. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to put my sleeping bag underground. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to fight the 7-day horde. And if I die, I'm not going to get spawn killed over and over again. I don't mind fighting the 7-day horde. I don't mind staying up top. But I am not going to just die over and over again through spawn killing. That doesn't make any sense. Or maybe I could put my sleeping bag in my house. I don't know. But it's definitely not going to be in my defensive structure. I don't know what to call the defensive structure. The defensive structure is going to be a 5x5 mini tower that's going to be hollow with spikes on the first floor, and it's going to have spikes all around it it's going to have a mixture of trussing and iron bars so I can shoot down at the zombies coming in. It's not going to be like too great of a structure, but what I'm going to do is I'm going to make multiple ones. I'm gonna make one next to it. So what can happen is there'll be modular. So like let's say like one starts getting beaten down, I could just go to the other one. It's gonna be pretty sweet. Man, this axe has been really cool. By the way, did they change something with the skills? Because I'm seeing right here on the... Oh, maybe that's because... Well, hold on. Let's make a regular stone axe. We're going to need plant fibers. A couple stones. And some wood. Yeah, they actually fixed the trees, too. The 1,000 hit point trees give proper wood now. So, that's good. Let's make a stone axe. Because I was seeing with the stone axe that... the crafting part of the stone axe is in the same tool group as the pickaxe, yeah, toolsmithing. So toolsmithing, okay, let's remember that. So if I go to toolsmithing, craft handheld and motorized tools faster, better quality, decrease repair penalties, and get more from repair kits. Gain this skill by crafting and repairing from these items. I've crafted quite a few stone axes, haven't I? Shouldn't that skill be more than two? Maybe I haven't. Maybe I haven't, because you know what? I did get this Taza Stone Axe pretty early. So maybe like my tool skill's so low because I haven't been crafting them because I haven't needed to make them. That could be it. It's just confusing to me. Oh. Stop wasting arrows. I can never tell when they're dead. And I don't feel bad about that because nobody else can either. Oh man, you just got destroyed, woman. Alright, let's see what we got here. There's something over there. Is that the... Yeah, it's the military camp. So we're going this way. So yeah, like I said, I need to decide if this is somewhere I'm going to stay or not. It's actually a really good place to stay. That house I want to stay at. It's a really good spot. It's just, it's tough because I need places around here to hit. If I can't get loot, you know, I'm not going to get the guns I need to protect myself, basically, is what it boils down to. That's not bad. Here, let's kill this dude. Okay. Shoot you right in the throat, bro. There we go. Nothing. Okay, so where do we go here? I've been here before, haven't I? This is where I wanted to decide which way to go. I say we're gonna go this way. Yeah, let's go this way. Wish me luck. I brought the wrench, didn't I? Let's start taking some of these cars apart. Okay. Loot them. Oh my god, that loot time. Come on, I need better scavenging. Oh, that's another thing. The Quality Joe perk. You gotta put a point in it every time you start. Oh, it's not letting me? You do not have the required skills. What? Oh, it costs 10 points. Okay, I didn't see that. Okay, so they must have changed the Quality Joe perk. You now need 10 points in scavenging and 10 points for Quality Joe. Okay, fair enough. That's fine. Did they really need to take it away from me, though? Come on, give me a battery. I need a battery. Sounds a little loud, doesn't it? You guys let me know what you think about the audio. I'll turn it down to 30. Let me know what you guys think the audio is good at. 30? Should I go lower? What? Okay. Okay, just took that car completely apart. I'm probably going to start cutting out some of that car scrapping stuff, man, because that is rough. That is rough to watch. I'll probably show you the first part of it, because I think that's where you get the best loot. Like, on the first... You know, before it degrades at all. Seem to get a lot of springs. It's good. I actually want to make the blunderbuss. I don't know what I'm going to, but... Okay, yeah. I don't think we get anything really good past this... Past that level. So, yeah. Okay. Let's keep going. Come on, man. Give me something... Give me a town or something. Give me a town, bro. Need a town, pimps. Look at this guy. This guy's got problems. Look at him. Oh, you know what? I'm running out of food. I do have some dog food. Let's go. There we go. That's very good. Water's getting a little low. Let's go ahead and drink. We're gonna scrap this up. Let's take a look at these boots. 8% and 8%, huh? Mine are... Whoa, why are these so bad? Is it just because they're, like, almost... No, these are pretty bad, aren't they? 8% and 8%? Well, they are worn boots. They are old. Oh, Jesus. Get out of my face, yo! That's what you get! What up? Oh, Jesus! So these zombies apparently have what I like to call the 7 days die, the left for dead. No. They have what I like to call the walking dead effect, where they're silent as a ghost until they attack you and then they start yelling. You ever notice that in the walking dead? Yeah, well, it's happening in this game too. All right. No, don't repair. No, no. Stop, 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 stop. Ah. Scrap. My bad. Oh, I can't scrap that. All right, whatever. Drop. Drop. That's pretty good for now. Let's keep going. Yeah, the Walking Dead effect. Like, they'll be like doing whatever they're doing on the Walking Dead, and they're looking out or whatever, and all of a sudden there's like a zombie jump behind someone and grab them, or like someone will just like there'll be like a horde coming up on them out of nowhere, and the zombies are always really loud except for when they're sneaking up on you. Yeah, like what? I'm telling you, that's exactly what goes in the Walking Dead. It's hilarious. I'm gonna carry this meat on me. I'm not gonna worry about it. A lot of people are saying don't worry so much about the meat, and you're probably right. Cause here's the thing: if you're that worried about the meat, if they're gonna get that close to you, the meat actually doesn't smell that bad when it's in your bag. See, the smell range in the bag. Well, bag smell range is 20. I don't know what that means, but they're probably gonna see me before they smell that anyway. I'm not gonna worry too much about it. If they come anywhere near me, I'll just kick their ass. Okay, so hold on to that. We'll get rid of this. Drop. Is that better than what I have? You know, we need a compare option. They look about the same. Well, this is 154, so gotta go with the 154. Scrap that. Scrap that. Come on, give me something good. I can't believe how far I'm going with no towns. This is kind of starting to worry me a little bit. I might not be able to stay in this area. Come on, give me a battery. I need a battery. I like to get oil out of these cars. That's really nice. When I finally do get my guns, I'm gonna have what I need to repair them at least. Come on, battery. Nope. I got some gas out of this. It's pretty cool. Alright, I'm gonna have to start ignoring cars because I really want to find out where the towns are. Is it a burnt biome? Oh god, look at all the smoke. That's definitely a burnt biome. You don't want to go into the burnt biomes, right? I don't know. Even though I could easily kill this guy with a club, it still makes sense to use the bow because you're trying to up your archery skill. God, look at this guy's head. Like, seriously. Alright, I'll just shoot him in the body. Man. Okay. The zombies also get up on you a lot quicker than they used to. So, that's something you gotta be aware of. Is there anything I can get rid of? Well, let's get rid of one goldenrod and... ugh. Let's get rid of the cotton. Alright, I'm gonna go check this area out. Do I have any glass jars with me? See, the problem is I cleared up my inventory before I came out here, so now I don't have a lot of stuff I want. Like, I want to fill up my glass jars in case I come across a water source. But I can't. So... alright, these are crap. These might just have a cool factor. Oh, I could put these on anyway. These have nothing to do with anything except for just give you defense, so that's good. Yeah, that looks badass. That looks badass. Alright, what else can I do? Can I do anything else? It does not look like it. Alright. Hey, you. Ooh, scavenging 13. Very good. I like that. All right, guys, let's dance. Jesus, you're taking a lot of shots, bro. See, the thing is, I found a melee weapon that's so much better than the bow I'm using. So it's really like when I'm using the bow, it just sucks. corpse. And a bag. Come on, give me some food and drink. Oh, there we go, machete. So let's take a look at the, this is supposed to be the best weapon in the game, although this is a pretty crappy machete. So maybe that's not that good. We'll just hold on to it. Alright, more bow and arrow practice. More archery practice, I should say. Man, you're tough. Not tough enough. That. Oh my god, this is crazy. Alright, hold on a sec. Let's eat that. Chest. And put this down. I can't be messing around. Actually, I should have looted him first anyway. There we go. Throw this out. Let's drop some crap off in this chest. Alright, I still hear zombies in the area, but I don't see them, so... Alright, let's continue looting. We looted that. I don't think there's anything else in here. Did we get all that? Yeah, we did. Okay. Anything in here? Oh, fireplace is out. Oh man, I lit myself on fire, damn it. I thought it'd be okay to walk over it because it was, let's just use one of these. That puts it out. I thought it'd be okay to walk over it because it wasn't, like, flaming or anything, but, you know, it's probably still hot, so. Not my finest moment. Alright, if I can avoid the smelling, I should. As a matter of fact, before we forget... chest. Okay, we're still okay here. There's something going on over in that woods. I'm gonna go check it out in a minute. Hope it's not a bear. Okay. Oh, there we go. There's a house. Yeah, I'm not gonna pause the videos. I have the forge iron with me? I didn't know that. We don't need any of this stuff. We don't need that. Did I put... No, I didn't. Okay, we're good. Let's go. We'll check out this house, and then we're probably gonna have to head home. Or I could just stay in this area. I mean, is there any reason to head home? Right? I mean... Is there any reason to head home? I do kind of need food. It would be nice to go home and eat up. We'll see. I'll think about it. Because I could definitely stay in this house overnight. So I can hit these guys. That went through her neck. I can hit these guys. It's just they have to be pretty close. Alright, what about you? You die now! Alright. Your ass. Check it out, we'll do this one. Oh no. Oh, that's right. I was pressing the wrong button. See? Take apart the air conditioner. I'm not gonna do that right now, though. We'll come back and get that. You're dead. The nurses are pretty cheap. Okay, did good there. Alright. See, yeah, it just takes practice. Alright, what do we got in here? Give me something good, man. Give me something good. Ah! Shut up. Gotta break through this. No. No, we don't. Oh, the windows are just as bad. No, they're not. Actually, a little bit easier. So you can't get leather from these cat. Oh, this one's got 200. What the hell? I wonder if this one's upgraded more. Nah, whatever. My guy's cold. All right, let's take. Whoa, where's my cowboy hat? I guess I didn't bring it with me. Man, I think I'm gonna start carrying a jacket with me now, cause yeah, now the coldness is becoming an issue, which is cool. I'm glad about that. That's pretty cool. Oh my god, these doors are all locked. Probably gonna stay here tonight now that I got some food. I'm not gonna break through this stuff without you here. What I'll do is I'll loot the stuff that's here, we'll call the video, and then I'll break through that stuff, and then we'll loot next video. Come on. Need some more food. Give me some food, brah. Something. Nothing else here to loot? Couple more things. We're gonna scrap you. Scrap you. Scrap. Scrap. Okay. Alright guys, we're gonna call this one. I'm gonna break through these things off camera, and then we will loot in the beginning of next video. So that's gonna be it for episode 10. We'll see you next time for episode 11. Till then, take it easy.